This is All India Radio, Bangalore.
Hello friends, welcome to Yuvaavani.
Dear friends, welcome to this youth program. We have with us A. Santosh. He is presenting a program on enlightening as a way to empowerment. Always it is required to empower the people, isn't it? Empower the people around us. Because if you don't give power to the persons who belongs to you, who depend on you, they always depend on you. They will never be independent and your work will be more. And more than that, if they are not empowered, they will not be enlightened. If they are not enlightened, they will fear to face the society, they will fear to face the responsibilities. That's how enlightenment is more important. Through enlightenment, empowerment is very easy. Santosh is having some examples. He is telling some stories. How to enlighten ourselves. Through enlightenment, how do you get empowerment? So let's listen to A. Santosh.
Dear friends, my name is Santosh Avvannavar. Today I will share few stories on enlightenment is the way to empowerment. Stories that connect, stories that spark, stories that create curiosity, and stories that lend newer perspectives. If we want to empower, especially the woman and the needy, first let's learn to keep aside our experience and exposure at times. One who does this will learn a new thing. Let me bring you a first story to this. There is a man who was living in the same area for the last 30 years. While going for a regular walk, he sees a little boy standing on a highway. He asks his little boy, "Hey little boy, what are you doing here?" The boy looks up to the man and says, "Uncle, I'm waiting for a bus." The man listens to it and replies, "Hey little boy, I live in the same area for the last 30 years. The bus doesn't stop here." There's a bus stop pointing to a distance. The boy, being adamant, says, "Uncle, I told you the bus will come here." The man thinks maybe the child is playing, and the man starts to walk. After a few steps, the man looks back and sees the little boy standing in the same point, not moving an inch. See, the 30 years of experience cannot make one fail. Don't you think so? The man walks back to the boy and says, "Hey little boy, don't you understand and believe my experience? The bus doesn't stop here." The boy looks up to the man again and says, "Uncle, I told you the bus will come here." The man thinks and awaits next to the boy, thinking, how come this is possible? Because he's living in the same area for the last 30 years and the bus has never stopped for him. After a moment, he sees a bus coming, approaching towards the little boy, and stands exactly the same point. To the surprise of the man, he thinks even the little boy doesn't show the hand, but still the bus stopped. How come this could happen? The little boy quickly gets into the bus and takes the window seat, and the boy leans out of the window and says, "Uncle, I forgot to tell you, the driver of the bus is my father, and that is why the bus stopped here." I'm sure this story tells us that each day could be a new beginning. Let me end the first story with the thought that if you want to win a heart of a person, first win the perception. If you want to win a heart of a person, first win the perception. I'm sure many times because of our experience and exposure, probably you have stopped learning because we think we know things. Now, in order to empower people, especially the woman who needs to be empowered, we need to change the gender stereotyping. Let me bring you a story number two for this. As a tradition, after the birth of a newborn in the family, what we do, generally we distribute sweets, right? And same thing happened in one of the family where they went to distribute the sweets to the neighborhood and invite them for the naming ceremony. I'm sure we all mostly seen in the various culture. The elderly woman of the family reaches out to the people with sweet to spread the news. All the neighbors with their children flocked to see the newborn, but everyone was shocked as the name was given out to the baby, a girl name was given. As the neighbors had received a sweet called as Peda, and this implied that it was a boy, but to their surprise, it was a girl. All the gifts that were brought for the naming ceremony to the child were for the boys. This tells us that we start discrimination in the society that starts from the womb and continues till the tomb. Often, if a girl baby is born, sometime a sweet like jalebi is given, assuming that the girl is a burden, she is a marriage material and expenses towards it. The second story tells us that we need to remove the rules that are set from the beginning of birth. Maybe we never have to have a rule what is for a boy and a girl. In order to empower, an educated mother could make difference, and switch of roles is a need of our. Let me tell you another story how anybody could play any role in the home and results in the office. I lived in a very simple small town and the life was simpler. I finished my primary schooling and moved to high school. My father was a government servant and I think he had desired that his son would join similar profession. And I feel that is perfectly right to have a dream. In our country, even if parents would let the children to decide career option, but we know that our relatives or distant neighbors or people around us often remarks and reminds about the future. One day, my father asked me, "Son, come here." He asked me, "What do you want to be?" And I was a little not in my school has any other children. So I put my head down, rolling my eyes with shyness and hidden smile that was visible to my father. He assured not to disclose about my feelings to anyone. I slowly looked up to father and said, "Dad, I want to be a house husband." He burst out of laugh on hearing and asked me why I want to be a house husband. The conversation had geared to open up, and I appreciate my father for never saying no for one's desires. I told him, "If I become a house husband, life is very simple." He asked me how. I said, "Dad, make little breakfast and send your wife to the office. Once she goes to the office, put television on to watch soap serials of Ekta Kapoor like Kabhi Saas Bhi Kabhi Bahu Thi and Kahani Ghar Ghar Ki. Once the serials are done, make a nice table full delicious lunch to eat stomach full till the stomach blows out like a balloon. Now because the stomach is heavy, take a nap for 2-3 hours. In the evening, go to the neighbor's house to discuss on today's episode. Why did mother-in-law or daughter-in-law did like that? What would happen in the next episode? Once the throatful discussion finishes, return back to home to receive your wife. On her arrival, go to the window shopping, but do not buy anything, otherwise how would one kill time tomorrow?" My father heard me patiently and quipped before he got up to leave for work, "It's possible you could be the first house husband of our country." On a lighter note, the story what I'm trying to say you is, there could be a shift in the change of hour, and that shift is probably required in case people want to make choices in life. Because I feel roles aren't defined to make a norm. Let's learn and accept the individual choice to make a society a better place and safe place to live. Don't you think so? Another dimension, many times one dimension perception can be an influencer and might be a blockage for empowerment. So let me tell you another story on this, of a perception with prescription. I title it as Perception with Prescription. One day, I got up from the sleep, went to a dad who was reading the newspaper. I said to him, "Dad, I have a dream." He asked me, "What is it?" "Dad, I want to go to London." After listening to this, he started reading the newspaper more seriously. It was like asking him to get me married to a well-known celebrity's daughter, and in such situation, parents can only listen and sympathize for such dreams. As a child, I was annoyed with no response. Hence, I pulled out the newspaper from his hand and said again, "Dad, I want to go to London." To which he asked me, "Why do you want to go to London?" I said with a smile, "Dad, there is something called as London Bridge. Have you heard it?" To which he nodded and I said to him, "Dad, I want to go to London Bridge. Stand on London Bridge and sing a song, London Bridge is Falling Down." He gave a big smile, listening to me patiently, and he thought for a while and put his hand on the wallet. I'm sure all of us love when parents give you money, right? Seeing him take out the wallet, I was excited and started to see to dream come true. I started imagining that I'll go to London and do what I wish today. After a moment, he pulled out and gave me rupees 100. In a calm voice, he said, "Son, there's a dam near our home, and that is Almaty Dam. Go practice there, and if you're successful there, you'll be successful in London Bridge. Go and practice." As you know that as a child, I was annoyed and started to show my tantrums. I got very angry. I started saying maybe some tantrums can help me to get my dream fulfilled. So I told my dad, "Dad, from today onwards, I'll not go to school at all." He looked at me with his lowering glass and said, "Thank God you saved my school fees. Don't go to school," he said. See, it did not work out for me. Then I tried, okay, let me say something else. I thought for a while, I used other tantrum. I told him, "Dad, from today on, I'll not talk to you." Then again, he smiled at me and said, "A lot of peace at home. Don't talk. Stay quiet." I know this also did not work for me. Then I thought, okay, let me use an emotional touch. I said, "Dad, from today onwards, I'll not eat food at all at home." He said, "Wait for a moment." Then he called my mother and said, "Don't feed him from today onwards. Let him starve. Let him be martyr for our life. And we'll believe that our son died for better mental life." On the lighter note, what I'm trying to say you is, it was very easy for him to give money and send me to London. After several years, I went to London with my savings and I went to the London Bridge and sang the same song, London Bridge is Falling Down, and remembering my father's words. He had told me that there will be several people who will discourage your dreams, but always carry a prescription that will not allow the perception to be an influencer. I had a big lesson to learn that, because he also told me that there are several ideas that fail in mind, not on paper, and many don't fail in reality if you try hard. There is another challenge to enlighten oneself and empower others, and that is fear. Let me tell you a story of a faithful fear. There were two people, one named Mr. Fear and another Miss Fear. Mr. and Miss Fear were faithful fear worshippers. Believe it or not, that they were so much faithful that they did not marry out of fear, in spite of being in love for last decade. Firstly, they had fear of falling in love and issues with handling relationships. Once this hurdle seems movable, then they had a fear of acceptance from families and social acceptance. This followed with a fear of future, such as children and their growing demands and social security. At times, they were afraid of each other. This fear actually started with failing in school and continued to struggle at academics. This failure gripped from performing better at work. When trouble ran at work, they were afraid of being unemployed. They spent several years worrying about too many things. This fear eventually caused sickness, and prolonged sickness caused mental illness. This led to heart failure and premature death. So my question is, why Mr. and Miss Fear remained so faithful to fear? I'm sure we all undergo such kind of fear. Unfortunately, Mr. and Miss Fear did not close the doors and shut out their worries about past, its mistake and failure. They did not also shut out needless fears of future, so they could have lived for just that day alone. Why did they wear raincoat when it is not raining anywhere near them? If one looks closely to worries, there are only a minor percentage of valid reasons for their worries. If the above said is true, how could one overcome fear? The answer might sound simple by simply having faith. As faith is just opposite to the fear, and they cannot occupy mind and heart at the same time. It goes on with the natural law of physics that states, two bodies cannot occupy the same place at the same time. Faith is like a light that shoo the darkness out. I hope one who takes away the fear which is dear when it is near, they will be able to enlighten themselves, enlighten others, empower themselves and empower others. We could create a social model where people who are in need, for example, a woman who wants to work, but there are a lot of taboos that are stopping her from stepping outside the house. What can we do for them? I am taking a case of empowerment that allows not only necessarily based on revolutionary method. We need not be a revolutionary people always to make things happen for people who are needy, because revolutionary method is not always the right method for a transformation. It could be one of the method to way of empowerment. I also believe there could be a transformation that could be in incremental form that will not disturb the norms of society completely, neither it will be a painful process for somebody to, you know, create a new kind of transformation. It could be like incremental form where there is a breathing space, evolve an ecosystem. Empowering people through their enlightenment, I feel, is the most easiest and possible way. What do you think about it? Thank you.
Dear friends, you have been listening to A. Santosh on the topic Enlightenment, a way to empowerment. Dear friends, now let us listen to Kaashif Buldavani. He is a poet in Urdu language and he has some shairis he tells in Hindi. They are very interesting. Those stories are being translated to English by Santosh. Moreover, Santosh is interviewing Kaashif, and let us listen to the poetry of Kaashif, and let us get the meaning of those poetries in English also. Let us listen to Santosh and Kaashif.
Hello friends, I am Santosh Avvannavar. Today we have a poet, Kaashif Buldavani. On behalf of young listeners, let us welcome Kaashif Buldavani to All India Radio Bangalore.
Hello everyone. Thank you Santosh and All India Radio Bangalore.
Welcome Kaashif again.
Thank you.
Now let me tell you why a poet is important. He's going to talk and discuss on poetry. A poetry is a powerful tool and an art to study at any age. And that is the beauty of poetry. It is a way to understand how languages and symbols systems work. As poetry uses language in specific and unusual ways, it draws attention to the written words. It is an art form that has survived thousands and thousands of years. Poetry can transfer the way we perceive language, the pattern of sentences sound new and melodious. So let us have a small discussion with poet Kaashif Buldavani and let us hear some of his poems he has written in Hindi. Mr. Kaashif, could you please introduce yourself to our listeners?
Yeah, sure. My name is Kaashif Latif Sheikh. I am from Buldana, which is a district place in Maharashtra. But currently I am working in Pune in a private company, Entangles Lab Private Limited, as a field engineer. I am also a poet. I write shayari in Urdu and Hindi.
Oh, that is interesting. You being an employee of a company and you also have passion towards writing poetry. So it is nice to hear that you have interest towards poetry. Could you tell us to our listeners at what age did you start to write poem?
Yeah, sure. When I was in junior college, my Urdu lecturer Shafiq sir was my inspiration. He is a very good poet and I inspired from him. He taught the subject in that way that everything is happening in front of us and he said many poetries in his lectures.
Oh, he taught each subject in the form of an poetry. Is that so?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, that's interesting. Can you tell to our listeners one of that example, how he taught, how he used poetry as a mode or a medium to teach a subject?
Once he said a poetry, which I remember till now. हमें ही फुर्सत नहीं नजरे लड़ाने की, हमें ही फुर्सत नहीं नजरे लड़ाने की, वरना खिड़कियाँ आज भी करती है इशारे.
Oh, wow, okay. Now, there is a message which he was trying to pass to you to pay attention in the class, and perhaps that was a way to tell to the students. Yeah, we understand the purpose of poetry for most of people is the existence, because that enables of passing of stories between generation. So this is one of the reasons why I think poetries are survived, because they tell a story to each one of us. Now, having said this, can you tell us who are your inspiration for you being a poet?
Back from Shafiq sir, all the shairs that like Mirza Ghalib, Rahat Indori, Kumar Ishwas, they are very good poets.
Okay. And any particular characteristic of a poet you like?
Rahat Indori.
Okay. What do you like in him?
The character is played in while telling shairi, his action and his...
the simplicity which you talk about. The way he presents his in simple lines.
Simple lines.
Could you tell to our listeners one or two such shairi of Rahat Indori?
जब कभी भी मिलेगा झिझोड़ दूंगा उसे जहां जहां से वो टूटा है जोड़ दूंगा उसे ये तो कमाल है उसका कि वो मुझे छोड़ गया इरादा तो मैंने किया था छोड़ दूंगा उसे.
वाह 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 वाह. So people like poetry, I think, because it tells that something about their life. I think I'm sure through poetry we try to tell a message. We try to tell about us. And a poetry is also a way of finding words for people when they cannot find it themselves. So maybe you help other people through poetry. Now, having said this, can you tell us one or two shairis which you have written to our listeners?
Yeah, sure, Santosh. This is one ghazal of mine. Ummeedon ke raaste nikal hi aate hai, jahan koshishon ke kadam badhaye jaate hai. फिर कुछ भी नामुमकिन नहीं होता जहां मेहनतों से काम बनाए जाते हैं. रास्तों में तो पत्थर आएंगे बहुत, मगर पत्थरों से ही तो रास्ते भी बनाए जाते हैं. थम न जाना कहीं सफर में तुम, रास्तों में तो पड़ाव आते जाते हैं. लाख गलत मशवरे देंगी ये दुनिया, मगर फैसले तो सोच समझ कर ही लिए जाते हैं. अपनी आजमाइशों से कहीं घबरा ना जाना, असली हीरे ही तो अक्सर परखे जाते हैं. पहाड़ों की तरह तन कर न हमेशा खड़े रहना, सुना है झरने भी इनसे रास्ते निकाल जाते हैं. बीच समंदर ही नहीं जान का खतरा, साहिल पर भी जहाज डूब जाते हैं. सूरज की तरह न जलना हमेशा काशिफ, सूरज की तरह ना जलना हमेशा काशिफ, जुगनू भी अंधेरों में रोशनी दे जाते हैं.
वाह 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 वाह. वेरी नाइस काशिफ, थैंक फॉर एन गिविंग अस एन इंटरेस्टिंग एंड इंस्पायरिंग पोयम. नाउ वी अंडरस्टैंड दैट अ पोएट्री परहैप्स इज मोर इफेक्टिव लाइक अ स्ट्रेस रिलीफ, राइट काशिफ? डू यू बिलीव दैट?
या या,
बिकॉज इट अलाउज यू टू एक्सप्रेस योर फीलिंग्स एंड इट ऑल्सो अलाउज यू टू टेल वॉट यू थिंक एंड यू वॉन्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड अदर्स. सो हैविंग सेड दिस, आई ऑल्सो हर्ड दैट यू राइट वेरियस पोएम्स. हाउ मेनी पोएम्स हैव यू रिटन टिल डेट?
कैन नॉट टेल यू द एग्जैक्ट नंबर, बट आई रोट many poems.
Okay, could be some 50, 100,000.
Less than 50.
Okay, but you've started writing it.
Yeah.
Okay, that's interesting. So have you thought anytime that you want to write a book so that you can reach to more people, so people know you more and use that in that part of life?
I didn't think about that, but if I got chance, I surely do that.
I hope you write a book on so that it reaches to a lot of young people in hand and they get motivated and inspired through your poems.
Yeah, sure.
Could you tell us which is your best poem that which you want to tell to everybody in the world? No, that is something which you want to pour out to everybody.
Yeah, sure. This is one of my ghazal. It is short but sweet.
Okay.
जो समझे वही समझे, जो ना समझे उन्हें क्या समझे, जो समझकर समझाए किसी और को, उनसे पूछो तो कि वो क्या समझे, हम तो समझे थे कि वो सब समझे, मगर वो बोले कि कुछ समझे, कुछ नहीं समझे, अब बताओ इस हाल में क्या करे काशिफ, जो जज्बात को भी सिर्फ अल्फाज समझे.
Okay, this is a lot of and like an puzzle dazzle, which is going like and difficult to understand, like a twister, which is like I think takes time for people to understand. Yeah, having said this, I also heard that you do something called as challenges. You take up challenges where people can write in English and you could rewrite that in a poem in the form of an Hindi. Is that right?
Yeah.
So let us try doing maybe a couple of such experiments.
Yeah, sure.
Where I give you a challenge, I will read out a poem to you in English and you think through it, tell that in Hindi. Is that okay? Are you open for the challenge, Kaashif?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so let's begin with the first one. The first poem which I have written, it is called as Bygone is Bygone. So I'm going to read out to you, give you a minute moment and you can start translating as we go on. Shall we, Kaashif?
Yeah.
Bygone is bygone. There was a time to see the shadow. There was a time to see the moon. There was a wind to feel. Now where is the time for see and feel? Bygone is bygone. Air was filled with innocence, innocence of accepting life as it came by. Nothing came easily and nothing passed through easily. Time and money were not part of make relationships. Now where is the time and money? Bygone is bygone. Celebration brought everyone and everything that did not fall in the frame of honor and pride. Now where are everyone and everything? Bygone is bygone. Over to you, Kaashif.
Let me think. Yeah. कहाँ गया वो गुजरा जमाना, खिलौनों से दिल लगाना, छोटी छोटी आँखों में बड़े बड़े ख्वाब सजाना, हवा के तेज बहाव में कागज का जहाज उड़ाना, कहाँ गया वो गुजरा जमाना, बिन मतलब के रिश्ते निभाना, औरों की खुशी में खुश हो जाना और गम में आंसू बहाना, छोटी छोटी यादें लंबा फसाना, कहाँ गया वो गुजरा जमाना, अपनों का साथ निभाना, दुश्मनों को भी गले लगाना, मुश्किलों में भी मुस्कराना, कहाँ गया वो गुजरा जमाना.
Wow, that was very quick and you were able to translate in a no time. So I think let me give you one more experiment on the same thing. Shall we, Kaashif? Shall we do one more challenge?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, this is a poem which I wrote about a common man, and this tells about story of a common man, how there is a hope for a common man. Okay, so I'm going to read to you out. This is a 3-paragraph poem and then I'll allow you a minute or two to translate. As you listen, you can continue to pen it down and we will see this challenge. Shall we?
Yeah, sure.
The poem goes like this. Little light from lantern, little hope to light, little gift from God, and the story of a common man is born. Little faith from fate, little drop of faith, little faith built family, and the story of a common man is born. Little in search of love, little love from lovable, little love built dreams, and the story of a common man is born. Kaashif, over to you.
Okay, let me think. We can say that जब चिराग से रोशनी आनी शुरू हुई, उम्मीदों की एक निशानी शुरू हुई, जैसे खुदा की तरफ से तोहफा सा मिल गया, एक आम से आदमी की कहानी शुरू हुई, हौसले से हौसले की रवानी शुरू हुई, उम्मीद थोड़ी छूटी, बदगुमानी शुरू हुई, आसरा सा मिल गया घर हो जैसे, एक आम से आदमी की कहानी शुरू हुई, प्यार की तलाश में जिंदगानी शुरू हुई, प्यार से ही तो प्यार की जुबानी शुरू हुई, छोटी सी मोहब्बत बड़े ख्वाब दिखाती है, एक आम से आदमी की कहानी शुरू हुई.
Wow, Kaashif.
Thank you.
I think that is a uniqueness you have, and this is probably a unique quality which you possess as a poet, where you have an ability to translate from one language to other language and give an uniqueness to the language what you hear from, and you use those words to convey the meaning and communicate beautiful ideas, the feelings and the sounds and gestures and signs and symbols which you use to tell this the beautiful message to people, I'm sure is going to touch a lot of hearts of people. We wish you all the best. And friends, till now we heard from Kaashif Buldavani. On behalf of all our young listeners and All India Radio Bangalore. We wish him all the best and our greater success ahead.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Santosh, for this opportunity.
I hope, listeners, you enjoyed today's talk. We will meet you again in the next week. Thank you.
Dear friends, you have been listening to the poetry of Kaashif Buldavani. He was interviewed by A. Santosh. With that, we shall come to the end of today's Yuvaavani. See you in the next program. Bye-bye.
This program came to you from the studios of All India Radio, Bangalore. Yuvaavani.